Today, we embark on a series about the Mesdames de France, the eight daughters of Louis XV. Unlike other daughters of the nobility who were born with the title Demoiselle, the daughters of the kings of France were born directly with the title of Madame. The eight daughters of Louis XV were given a number according to the order in which they were born. The first daughter was called Madame Première, the second one Madame Seconde, the third born Madame Troisième, and so on. Seven of the eight daughters of Louis XV and Maria Lisinska remained unmarried due to political and strategical circumstances. The eight Mesdames de France were Louise-Élisabeth de France, Anne Henriette de France, Marie-Louise de France, Marie-Adélaïde de France, Victoire de France, Sophie de France, Thérèse-Félicité de France, and Louise de France. To save on expenses at court, the four last-born princesses received an education in the Abbey de Fontevraud, where they spent their younger years before returning to Versailles. The older sisters remained at court as the king had grown too fond of them to be separated from them. The Mesdames were not fond of the mistresses of Louis XV. In particular, they did not like Madame de Pompadour. Upon the start of the French Revolution, only two of the eight sisters were still alive. The surviving sisters left France for Italy, where they spend the remainder of their lives. This week, we will start out with the first two of the eight sisters, Madame Première, Elisabeth, and Madame Seconde, Henriette. Elisabeth and Henriette were twin sisters. They were born on August 14, 1727 in Versailles. The first sister, Louise-Élisabeth of France. Elisabeth was baptized on April 27, 1727 and was nicknamed Babette by her father. She was raised in Versailles in the princess wing alongside her twin Henriette, her sister Adélaïde and her brother, the Dauphin Louis. She quickly showed herself to be an intelligent and proud child. Elisabeth was well loved by Louis XV, whom she physically resembled very much. In order to reconcile with Spain, as the country was still outraged by the broken engagement of Louis with the Infanta Marie Anne Victoire in 1725, Louis XV had promised Elisabeth's hand in marriage to Philippe, the future Duc de Parma, who was the son of King Philippe V of Spain. Elisabeth married Philippe by proxy on August 26, 1739, at the age of 12. On August 30, she left Versailles for Spain and on October 25, 1739, the official marriage took place. The union between Philippe, Duc de Parma and Elisabeth produced three children, Isabelle, Ferdinand and Marie-Louise. Elisabeth quickly grew tired of the boring life at the Madrid court, so, when the opportunity arose, she visited the French court on December 11, 1748 to see her family, before she left for Parma. She was very happy to be back at Versailles and remained there until October 1749 before actually leaving for Parma. In 1752, Elisabeth's twin, Henriette, died. This prompted Elisabeth to return once again to Versailles. Although she was only meant to stay in France for a few weeks, she spent more than a year there. In 1760, Louise-Élisabeth's oldest daughter, Isabelle, was to be married to the Archduke of Austria, Joseph, the later Emperor Joseph II. In order to arrange the marriage, and for political reasons, Louise-Élisabeth left Parma again and once again took the opportunity to visit her home in Versailles. While in Versailles, Elisabeth's health took a turn for the worst when in December 1759 a smallpox epidemic broke out. Doctors were powerless and Elisabeth died on December 6, 1759 in Versailles. The second sister, Anne Henriette of France. Henriette, seeing how she was born after her twin sister, was named Madame Seconde, pending her baptism in Versailles on April 27, 1737. For economical reasons, the Prime Minister, Cardinal Fleury, convinced Louis XV to entrust the education of his daughters to the most prestigious convent in France, the Abbey de Fontevraud. The twins were exempt from going to the convent as negotiations for the union between Philippe and Elisabeth had already started. Henriette stayed at the Versailles court alongside her older sister Elisabeth, her younger sister Adélaïde, and her brother, the Dauphin Louis Ferdinand. When Elisabeth left Versailles in 1739 in order to be married to Philippe, the future Duc de Parma, the twins were heartbroken to be separated. Henriette was now the oldest daughter of the king to reside at court. Unlike Elisabeth, she never married. In 1745, the 15-year-old Dauphin married Maria Teresa Rafaela of Spain. During the wedding celebrations that followed, the king met Jean Poisson, later known as the Marquise de Pompadour. Henriette, the Dauphin Louis, his wife Maria Teresa, and their younger sister Adélaïde did not approve of the king's new mistress and formed a front against the Pompadour. They often refer to her as Maman Putain, which translates into Mother Whore. When Maria Teresa Rafaela died, 3 days after giving birth to a baby girl, the Dauphin had to remarry, and Josepha of Saxony was chosen. The Dauphin deeply grieved the passing of his first wife, so the marriage had a difficult start. However, Henriette intervened on behalf of Josepha of Saxony and managed to set things right between the young couple. In 1748, Henriette's twin sister, Elisabeth, returned to the French court for a short visit. To the delight of Henriette, her stay was extended to nearly a year. Henriette took ill in 1750, and at the age of 24, on February 10, 1750, she died. She was laid to rest in the Basilica de Saint-Denis in Paris. When her sister Elisabeth died in 1759, she was buried next to her twin. Thank you for watching this first part on the Mesdames de France. Next week, we'll discuss the third, fourth, and fifth of the Mesdames. I hope you'll join me.